Grape City Documents introduces a JavaScript-based image viewer control that lets you view and edit various image file types in all modern web browsers using the latest JavaScript frameworks. In this video, you will learn how to start working with Grape City Documents image viewer control, how to configure the image viewer to be used in a web application, followed by loading an image file, and later, demonstrating how to add plugins to provide additional functionality through the viewer. Let's start by creating a new ASP.NET Core Web Application in Visual Studio 2022. Give an appropriate name to the project, let's say Image Viewer App. Choose Framework Version .NET Core 6.0. Configure any other settings required by your project. Open the NuGet Package Manager console by choosing Tools, NuGet Package Manager, Package Manager Console option. Switch to the lib folder found in the project folder by executing the cd command passing in the correct path to the folder. Install the GC Image Viewer package using the npm install command. To add the JavaScript-based GC Image Viewer control to the project, we will add a new HTML page to the project's www root folder and name it index.html. In the newly added HTML page, we will add a reference to the required JS script file at the top of the index.html page for GC Image Viewer. Next, we add code to configure GC Image Viewer control on the client side. We begin by adding a div element, which would be rendered as GC Image Viewer. We then define a script block to initialize an instance of GC Image Viewer class by passing in the div ID as a parameter. Invoke the open method of GC Image Viewer class to load an image file into the viewer on loading the web page. Also, we set the zoom settings for the viewer and image through code so as to get a proper view of the image being loaded into the viewer. Lastly, we will add the image file to be loaded in the viewer into the www root folder of the project folder so that it can be accessed via JavaScript code. To set the index.html as the startup page for the application, we will update the code in program.cs file to invoke the use default files method. This ensures that index.html is loaded by default when the application is executed. Save, clean, and rebuild the solution, and then execute the application to see how the image viewer works with a loaded image in your default browser. As you can see, the image loads with the whole image zoom setting set through the code. You can alter the same setting either by choosing another option from the Zoom dropdown or typing in a custom value in the Zoom text box. In the last section of this video, we will learn how to add a plugin to GC Image Viewer to enhance further the edit functionality offered by the viewer. You can find all the available plugins under the Plugins folder inside the GC Image Viewer folder. As you can see, we have Page Tools and Image Filters plugins. The Page Tools plugin offers basic edit functionalities such as crop, resize, rotate, and flip, while the Image Filters plugin provides the functionality of applying various built-in filters to images. We will be working with Image Filters plugin, so let's begin by adding the Image Filters JavaScript file to the index.html page. Next, we instantiate an instance of ImageFilters plugin class and add it to the ImageViewer by invoking the addPlugin method of GCImageViewer class. We set other options for ImageFilters plugin, including Show Sidebar Panel and Show Toolbar button, to show the filter options in the sidebar and the default toolbar, respectively. Save, clean, and rebuild the solution, and execute the application to see the image viewer with the image filter option added to the toolbar as well as to the sidebar panel. Clicking on the image filter button added to the toolbar displays a secondary toolbar to the image viewer with all the built-in filter options. You can choose any one option to apply the respective filter to the image. Here we apply an invert filter to the image, and the filtered image can be previewed by the viewer. We can apply the same filters even through the sidebar panel. Clicking on the image filter button added to the sidebar expands the sidebar to showcase all the filters, with the filter being applied to the original image and the filtered image showcased as a thumbnail image. You can choose any one option to apply the respective filter to the image. Here, we apply the grayscale filter to the image, and the filtered image can be observed by the viewer. Later, you can download the modified image on the client side by choosing the Download option from the Image Viewer toolbar. For more information, you may refer to product demos, blogs, and documentation available on Grape City website.